that without skipping a beat, without asking any more questions after receiving an invitation to this event, that he called me up and he said, I'll be there. And it is truly an honor to have James Roosevelt with us, to speak to us about his grandfather's legacy. So would you please join me in giving him a round of applause.
Buenos dias. And thank you for inviting me here today. It's great to be with you. I want to express my thanks to Nancy and to Salika for inviting me to join you today, to one of our other speakers that you're going to have speak with you in just a few minutes, Eric Kingson, who was a great scholar of Social Security, and to Dennis Tracy for all the work that the New York State Alliance for Retired Americans does. Thank you all for the great work you do. And it's a true privilege and honor to be on this program with Jesus Laviera. That was just a truly inspiring message that he delivered to us. Yes. Seventy-seven years ago, on August 14th, my grandfather, President Franklin Delano Roosevelt, said these words, "We can never ensure 100% of the population against 100% of the hazards and vicissitudes of life. But we have tried to frame a law which will give some measure of protection to the average citizen and to his family against poverty and old age." That captures what Social Security is fundamentally about. Can't protect everybody from every hardship, but we can try to provide basic security for people in old age, in disability, or when a parent was lost prematurely. My grandfather left many great legacies, but I believe the most central to all of us must be Social Security. His leadership in establishing Social Security transformed American society while also reflecting its most enduring values. I have to confess to you that today I am worried by the torrent of distortions and deceptions and falsehoods that the detractors of Social Security try to spread. We have now a presidential and vice presidential candidate who want to do away with Social Security on one side of the equation. We have to fight back. We have to support those who will continue Social Security. We have authors who spread falsehoods about Social Security and lead our children and grandchildren to believe it won't be there for them. Now, as was mentioned, I served as Associate Commissioner for Social Security, and I know that Social Security is financially sound, that it will be there not just through my lifetime and your lifetime, but through our children's and grandchildren's lifetimes. But what are the detractors trying to spread? They're trying to